Three girls, four guys. Everybody has to shower before they give you soap and tell you to wash your tits and bits or whatever, something like that. Everybody strips down, everybody gets in the shower. And then we hung out in a jacuzzi above a crowd of dancing people basically for an hour.
Hi, everyone. Welcome to They Had Fun. I'm Rachel, and I am back with another amazing story about New York City. And what did we think about the cold open, guys? I'm going to be honest with you. I just learned what that was this week. So your girl who's coming out with six podcast seasons for you is learning something new every day. I'm growing up before your very eyes. So yes, we have this new opening that I wanted to try. Genuinely, what did you think about it? Did you hear that and think, oh, I know, I really want to know what's going to happen. I'm going to stick around. Or are you like, oh my God, Rachel, you're giving it all up at the front. Please tell me your thoughts. I would love to know. But yeah, we've got that for the opening. We've got the whole theme for the sixth season. I don't know if you noticed, but we also have a new podcast cover. You might say They Had Fun is growing into its very own. And if you happen to be new here, I am Rachel. I interview New Yorkers about the most fun they've ever had in New York City. But for this season in particular, we are doing something a little bit different. And we are only having guests who have moved to New York City in the past 2 years. Now, if you're wondering why, the only real answer is I don't know. I want to prove people wrong or something like that. I guess that's kind of why the whole podcast started anyways. But I wanted to talk to people who are moving here because, you know, everyone is always saying, are people even still moving here with a hope and a dream and a prayer and a dollar in their pocket? And the answer is very much so. Yes, I can assure you of that. You're going to hear from them all this season. I have been recording over the past month and interviewing with these people, and let me tell you, they are coming and they are having a lot of fun. And I'm so excited for you guys to hear these stories. Some of them have truly floored me, honestly, including today's. It's the reason I picked it to be the premiere. I think you're going to love it. But now that we are officially back, why don't we get into what you've all been waiting for? It's the Rachel's Recs, and I've got two good ones for you. I'm coming out number one with a hot one. It is one I've kind of been sitting on a little bit. I don't want to say like I've been holding out on it, but I've been just waiting for the right time. It is now that time. It is Michael's on West 55th Street. Now, let me give you my little like elevator pitch on Michael's. Started in 1989, the hotspot for like media power lunches. You know, you hear that phrase like two martini lunch, which I don't even know how people do that. I'd be like falling apart, and I love drinking. We all know that. But so it used to be that, totally that style. Okay, so all of these kids out there, all you young kids, when you're wanting to do like Bemelmans and Monkey Bar and like that whole vibe is very popular, and I'm into it too, but like it's become very popular now. Everyone wants the martinis. Why not try out Michael's instead? Now, I'm not sitting here telling you that Michael's is going to be like super crowded and all the A-listers are there and all this jazz. It's actually kind of the opposite, which I think is one of the best selling points because it kind of deserves a glow up or what have you. Like, why aren't we going to Michael's? Okay, let me just sell you on some of the best things about this place. Okay, number one, not super crowded. You can get a seat at the bar. You don't have to elbow people out of the way. You also get a little cachet that you're like, oh yeah, I found Michael's first. And like, now it's just blown up. That always feels great when you say that to people. Okay, also they have about, I don't know, $2 million worth of artwork hanging on the walls. Gorgeous, amazing. Jasper Johns, Hockney. Like, this is some serious art world cred happening in this room. You know, everyone's really into conversation pits right now, and people are putting in conversation pits and they're really cool again. Well, guess what? Michael's has always had a conversation pit, and it's right by the bar. I'm telling you, you want classic New York, but like a little bit different, go hit up the bar at Michael's. I just went on Friday with a group of friends. None of them have ever been. It's a good excuse to go to Midtown. If you can't get into Monkey Bar, go over to Michael's instead. I don't know. Maybe They Had Fun will make Michael's blow up. I kind of hope that happens for them. If you go in there, if you see Johnny at the bar, if you see Bazdeo running the place, tell him Rachel said hi. I'm always telling that. I'm like, I'm going to tell people about Michael's. I want to get them in here. Like, they need my help or something. I mean, I'm at lunch, it's crowded. Whatever. You get the point. Go check out Michael's. Okay. Second recommendation for you. You know, I always struggle with like, should I be honest about what I'm really loving? Because sometimes it's things as stupid as riding a city bike or getting my shoes shined or etc. But I just have to do what I have to do to be honest with all of you. My second recommendation is going outside. Okay, so like hear me out here. I don't know. If you don't live in New York, maybe you don't understand how much the change in seasons truly, deeply affects all of us. We're all trapped in our tiny little apartments with nowhere to go, and it's freezing outside. Anytime we do go outside, we have to like trudge through the cold and the wind and walk to the bus and all that. But just this past weekend, we saw a little glimmer of hope. This Sunday, it was nearly 70 degrees in New York City. And as I predicted on our Instagram that New York City would lose its mind, that is exactly what happened. Everyone was out and about. I saw shorts. I was out about. I was walking. I was in East Village. I was in Soho. I was in West Village. I was rounding over to the West Side Highway. I was coming back through Chelsea. I stopped and got a drink in Union Square. It is everything you want. So I am saying to you, if you hear this, please just go outside. I don't know what that is for you. Maybe it's jumping on a bike and going to Queens. Maybe it's taking the ferry somewhere. Maybe it's sitting in a park by yourself. Or maybe it is just taking a really long walk in Manhattan and, I don't know, ending up in Midtown at Michael's and getting yourself a martini could be a really great day. I tell you guys, I got to tell you the truth about the things I'm loving in New York City. And right now I am loving that this weather is coming for us and that we can get the hell outside. I'm so stoked about it. Can you tell that I am excited to be back? I feel like I have this energy every time we come back from a break. And it's either delirious or very exciting to hear. So you let me know. Let's get into our show for today. This is a good one. I'm excited. Okay. My guest happens to be a friend of mine, but she also happens to be a restaurant professional and a bartender at where else? One of my absolute favorites, Company in Soho. Please welcome to the show, Leila Dayan.
Hi, thank you for having me. I'm so excited to be here. I've never done this before.
It's great that you have never done something like this before because that's the exact type of people that I'm looking for in this season. And as I know from being a friend of yours now, you have recently moved to the city. So when I was asking people if they wanted to be on the show and if you knew anyone, you were like, how about me? I would love to be on the show. I was like, oh my gosh, I didn't even know that you'd be interested in that. So now I have you and I get to tell everyone about, of course, which would really be no surprise to anyone who listens to this show often. I met you via Company, one of my favorite bars in the city. You currently work there. We have had another Company employee on the show. It has been a Rachel's Rec. It is one of my favorite places. I obviously met you out one night when we were all having a bit of fun, but you work at that bar. I see you there the most, all of those things. Tell us a bit about your work with Company, anything you do. We know you also work in food. Give it to me.
Well, I started working at Company about 2 weeks after I moved to the city.
Oh my gosh.
Well, I interviewed and trailed in 14 spaces in 14 days. Like it was like, I was looking for a job. I needed a job. I had no money when I moved here. And at first I trailed there and I told them I was going to take the weekend to think about it because I knew it would be a place that would take just a while to like get my footing under me, where other restaurants, I felt spaces would be a little bit more easier to navigate, but wine in general is a really hard thing to learn when you don't know anything about it. So I started working there and they put me behind the bar with Kaipo, who was on your show.
Yes.
Who is an old school bartender. And as you mentioned in your episode with him, just like works the room like nobody else and sets the vibe really, really well. And honestly, I feel like that's one of the things Company is known for more than anything else is the vibe that we have and
yes,
how it's such a great place to spend 5 hours in when you were going to spend maybe 50 minutes.
Totally.
And so I got to learn how to bartend from him and I got to learn wine from everybody in the space. And now a year and a half later into being in the city and being at Company, I'm the bartender there now. I'm pursuing different sommelier certifications and just like working on creating a really good community of regulars through Company, which is something they've been doing for 9 years. And I've been having a lot of fun doing for the last year and a half. But yeah, I was really furiously looking for a place to work because I moved to the city with no money, no job, and no apartment. I literally had $200 in an Airbnb that was $1,700 a month with 7 other people in Bed-Stuy and was just kind of desperate and was like, okay, like let's figure it out. And we did.
I'm so excited about stuff like this because this is the energy that I'm talking about. These are the people coming that I talk about. And doing 14 trails at restaurants in 14 days just requires a wild amount of work ethic, energy, everything. That is so cool. It talks so much about you. Now you're saying this thing that I'm going to go into this because you said this, but a big part of this thing about the sixth season is people arguing with me that people can only move to New York these days if their parents give them money. I haven't found a way to talk to people about this because I'm like, how do I even talk about that? But you're bringing it up that you're like, I moved here with no money. I moved here with like nothing. And I still believe firmly that people are coming just like you. And I can't wait to hear more about you being like, I had nothing. I just had to figure it out because I think a lot of people relate to that. And of course, there's a bunch of people coming who do have a shit ton of money, but that doesn't mean people like you aren't coming. And I'm so excited to talk to you about all of the ins and outs of that. I think we're okay, ready to just like get into the questions because we're going to start talking about those things. We learned about company. We learned about you being there for a while. And it is such a great place. I love it so much. Everyone should go. Everyone should go and see Leila because she does create a roster of regulars. That is one of the best things about that place. But let's get into our questions for the show. First up, when did you move to New York?
I moved to New York July 5th of 2022. I actually met you about 2 weeks after I'd moved to the city.
Oh my gosh. Really?
Yeah, at Spring Lounge around the corner. Food was always my passion, but it wasn't until COVID that I went to culinary school. So I had graduated from culinary school and then took myself to Mexico to eat for 2 months to congratulate myself.
Oh my gosh.
By the time I moved to New York, I had completely run out of money from the summer before moving here.
Perfect plan.
And I'd gone home. I was supposed to move here July 1st, but my mom broke her hand when I was home.
Oh.
Yeah, she fell and broke her hand. So I had to stay at home. And at that point, again, I was already 5 days into the Airbnb that I had booked for a month. Oh. And so again, time is already running out for me to find a job, because I was running out of money. So I get to the city, and after 1 week of looking for jobs and interviewing and trailing, I was really lucky because company was the first job that I got. And by the end of my first month, I had just enough money to rebook the Airbnb for the next month.
You gotta love the scrappiness of New Yorkers of like, you know, like when I moved here, we didn't have Airbnb. Like, of course, it's like, yeah, get an Airbnb, like throw some money. You can book it online. Like, it's easy enough. It is truly so very difficult to get an apartment in New York City, whether that's 30 years ago, 10 years ago, or yesterday. It's probably getting even harder and worse now, obviously. But you gotta love New Yorkers finding a way to like cobble it together. All right, I'm gonna get into our second question here because I think this is gonna be really interesting. It's always, why did you move to New York? We know obviously you left culinary school. We have that. You went to Mexico. You could have stayed there. You could have gone to LA. You could have done whatever. What is the reason that it was New York City for you to come with a little wish and a hope?
It's funny that you say that because I almost stayed in Mexico. That's a different story though. But one, a big thing, I don't drive.
God bless.
And I didn't grow up in the United States. I grew up in Costa Rica, and New York is where my parents met. And I went to school upstate, and it just kind of made sense because I didn't need a car. I knew people here. I was really tied to the industry here already. I'd worked at a restaurant here for 6 months during my extern during school. And I have more of a community here than anywhere else in the United States. But the real reason was just food and wine. I mean, there's no other place really like it. It's so accessible here. It's so everywhere here. And, you know, there's not many places in the world where you can walk into a Michelin star restaurant and just sit at the bar because you want to and because that's available to you, and just the diversity of food and culture around food. Like that's why I'm here.
I love that. I mean, I knew knowing you a bit that that's kind of what the answer was going to wind up being, but I love that. And I think it's one of the best things about New York. And the thing that I find so interesting, right, is like, whatever that thing is for you, it's food. It's some of the best food in the world. It is the best food in the world. I'll just say that. But for other people, it's like, it's the best dance in the world. There's the best artist in the world. There's the best, whatever it is, it's the best of everything. And for you to be like, I had a community here. I knew this was great, but also this is it. This is the pinnacle. And you kind of give me the chills a little bit there with like, oh, I can just go walk and sit at the bar at a Michelin starred restaurant. We are so lucky here. It's going to cost us a lot of money. Sure, maybe. But if you want to have that experience, it is there for you. And I am glad that that is one of the things that brought you to New York City. Okay. So considering that you came here to be a restaurant professional and that you're doing it and at one of the best places in the city and that you came here with just like a little hope and not much cash in your pocket. I love it. Why don't I ask you the most important question of the show? And that is, of course, Leila, what is the most fun you've ever had in New York City?
The most fun I've ever had in New York City was with a friend who shall remain nameless to this story. And I always have the most fun with this person. This person has such a big network, such a big friend group, which being in, you know, between your 20s and 30s as an adult in a city that you didn't grow up in is kind of a huge feat in of itself. Mm-hmm. Always just has lots of things to do, lots of options, always saying yes to everything. And this person planned a picnic in Prospect Park. It must have been really early summer. I don't even think I'd lived here a year yet. It was like just bordering on a year. And community was a really big deal to me when I first moved here, as it is to, I think, everybody making friends. And this person has a really big friend group, and they planned a picnic in Prospect Park, and they invited everybody that they knew, and like 15, 20 people showed up, and There was wine, there was food, there was weed, there was one of my friends came, hung out for 3 or 4 hours, just like had a really lovely time. Everything was so green and lush, and like it's amazing what green will do to like your brain. I feel like when you've been starved of it for so long, when it's cold and gross.
Oh God. Yeah.
And it was just perfect weather. It was a beautiful day. And before I had left my house, I was like, okay, like I hang out with this person and we always just have a great time. So it's kind of like an all day outfit kind of day. I don't know if you relate to this at all, where you know you're going to leave the house and you have no idea when you're going to come back. So you better wear something that'll be perfect for any event.
I love that. It is so specific to New Yorkers, that idea that of being like, I gotta be available for a 10 o'clock dinner reservation at a Michelin-starred restaurant, or I might be winding up at like a dive bar in Red Hook, but I gotta be looking both options.
Yeah, I gotta be comfortable. I gotta be good all day. So my
Yeah.
all day outfit was cargo pants and a crop top and sneakers because it was summer.
Cute.
And cargo pants are great because they have lots of pockets. I didn't need a purse. And it was wonderful. It was great. We had a great time in the park, hung out for a really long time, saw people that like I just met or was just meeting and like really trying to like forge more community bonds. And it starts to get late, not late, late, but it was getting cold and people were ready to disperse. And there had been talk about what we were going to do later. Everybody was going to meet up. People were going to go to a bar in Bushwick. Somebody else said we should go to House of Yes. Just lots of different options. And I was super along for the ride. So we go back to the same friend's apartment and they have like this really amazing loft and have a great roof. And we sat on the roof and smoked weed and watched the sun go down and just a lovely time. And then we ended up in Bushwick around 10 o'clock and just like went around a couple bars. Didn't really have any sort of like committal plans of what we were going to do, but there was like 8 of us. And then finally it's like, okay, it's like 1 in the morning. No, maybe like midnight. It's like, okay, we're going to go to House of Yes. That's what's going to happen. And at this point, I've already had a great day, you know, soaked in some vitamin D, hung out with some great people, bounced between some places in Bushwick, took a little mushrooms, having a great time, you know, but I'd never been to House of Yes and I'd wanted to go to House of Yes for a while. And
I just have to say, we're like, you are the way that you like really fast forwarded through, like, and it's midnight, and I took mushrooms. And it's like, we're not even to the story
no, we're not even at the story yet.
yet.
This is like the preamble. This is the really nice day before the story that adds into it being such a perfect New York day because the only plan I had was to go to a picnic for 4 hours. And
Always.
all of a sudden it's 12 hours later and, you know, I'm at the door to House of Yes being told the story on consent. And I was like, oh, I like this place.
Yeah.
And somebody else was paying my $50 cover charge, which, you know, that's always awesome.
Hell yeah. Okay.
And I go in and I was, you know, utterly, I wasn't as busy as I've been told it was because they had a private event in the back, but it was just, I mean, it was amazing. They're like, the music was incredible. The naked acrobats were incredible. The dancers were incredible. But the main reason we actually ended up at House of Yes was because at Prospect Park, there had been talk of the naked jacuzzi. I love that reaction. Again, not really paying attention to what's going on, just along for the ride. But some people had gotten there before, and I guess you have to put your name down. I'm sure there's like everybody wants to go, not everybody, but a lot of people I'm sure want to go in the naked jacuzzi. So like 10 minutes after we got there, they're like, Layla, are you coming? Are you coming? And I was like, where, like, sure, I guess, whatever. So we go up the stairs. There's like an outdoor area and there's like a like an above moment. And there's these stairs that go up and we walk up and there's a jacuzzi in the back and there's some couch seating. We sit down and a pirate man wearing prosthetic breasts and a skirt comes out and talks to us about consent. And I'm with 6 other people,
Oh my
three
gosh.
girls, 4 guys. Everybody has to shower before they give you soap and tell you to wash your tits and bits or whatever, something like everybody strips down, everybody gets in the shower, and then we hung out in the jacuzzi above a crowd of dancing people basically for an hour, smoking joints and drinking like Prosecco because he really liked us and gave us a bottle of Prosecco and hung out and had a really, really great time. And there was bubbles and it was fun and it wasn't sexual, which was the interesting
Yeah, I
thing.
was just gonna say, it sounded like it was just sheer fun and not necessarily
I
sexual.
only had known one of these people that I was in this water with 12 hours prior, also.
That's a
That's the
great
other
detail.
aspect. That's the other aspect of this. I met everybody that day,
I love
basically.
it.
Or like knew them kind of just like in passing, like hi at a house party.
Oh.
And then after an hour, they're like, all right, like time to let the next guests enjoy the ride. And they drain the tub between each use and they scrub it every
I
night.
am glad to hear all of the hygienics behind this
Yeah, no,
because
they're pretty serious about
it's
it.
infamous and I've never done it. I don't know, maybe I don't know if I can handle that, but I love it for everyone else. But I like to hear all the hygiene behind it. So that's great. Noted.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. They literally put the soap in your hands and are like, you need to use that. Yeah. You don't have a choice. But, you know, it was a great, fun, super fun experience. And then we went downstairs and just danced until like 4 a.m. I remember at one point I made the mistake of going into the bathroom and like looking at what I looked like. And the all day,
whoopsie,
the all day outfit was rocking. But the hair after the humidity, like you can't see it, but I got really big hair. Just like there was some like remnants of mascara under my eyes. And I remember running back out to the girls and being like, you didn't tell me I was ugly. And they were like, no. Because you know how girls are.
I'm sure you looked gorgeous.
Thanks. The cargo pants killed it. We danced just until 4 a.m. And then it kind of got to that point at the night where we were like, all right, well, you know, we're done. It's time to go. So said thank you for having us and kind of like wandered outside. Some people were like, oh, should we go to this place and dance till 6 a.m.? And I had been a little self-conscious about what I had looked like. So one of the girls that I was with took some like lip tint that she had and started dabbing it on my lips just because she was being sweet. And some random man came up and handed us both cigarettes and goes, this just feels right. And I was like, did this man just see this girl put lipstick on me and offer us free cigarettes without being prompted? I was like, that's female privilege to a degree that I've never known it. I was like, I don't understand. I still have the cigarette. I don't smoke cigarettes. I still have it in my room that I have in a shrine to women that I love. And I have the cigarette there because I'm like the feminine power. And everybody dispersed at that point. You know, the couples went home and I was left hanging out with my friend. And I was kind of like, I would love some food.
Yeah.
And the three of us go to get Mexican food, get really good Mexican food at this place kind of nearby. It was probably 4:30 at this point. And I was already looking at cars and had connected with a car that was like, and I live in Bed-Stuy, so I don't live that far. But I mean, it was not a walkable distance, especially at 4:30 in the morning. And I'd called a car and it was like 12 minutes away and it was coming to pick me up. And it canceled after like 10 minutes.
Oh God.
So now it's like 4:45. And my one friend at this point is real fucked up and needs to go home. So they just bolt. And I like, I don't even blame you. Go home. You've done a lot more than I have today. And I've done a lot. Go home. You need it. So I'm with their other friend who I had just met that night, who lived just around the corner and was kind of just like waiting with me until I got in a car, kept connecting to Ubers, kept getting canceled on.
Oh no.
5 a.m. at this point. And I'm like, all right, like, I don't know what I'm going to do. And I did not want to sleep at this guy that I don't know's house.
Mm-hmm, right.
And was getting a little nervous at this point and was checking the bus routes. There was a bus that was going to go by in like 10 minutes that would take me into Bed-Stuy, but it would still be a 20-minute walk to my house.
No, so late.
So I kept trying to connect to Ubers and it wasn't working. And I see the bus coming and they just kept canceling on me. And I was like, fuck it. Like, I just got to get on the bus. What else am I going to do?
Oh, gotta love an MTA bus.
So the guy walks me to the station. He says, good night. He's like, okay, like, let me know when you get home. And I was like, yeah, I will. Get on the bus. And the only other person on the bus is a girl who's clearly in the same situation that I am. There's no cars at dawn. And she's just like trying to get home. She's cold. girl, I feel you.
We're in this together.
I connected to an Uber just before I got on the bus and it hadn't canceled. And I was still connected to it because I was so worried. And I was just like DMing him furiously being like, are you going to cancel on me? Please let me know if you're going to cancel on me. Because otherwise he's like, what? No, like I'm on the way. Like I'm almost there. And then I see on the app that the bus is taking me closer to the Uber. And I was like, okay, please let this work. And I was like, if I get off the bus, will you pick me up right here? And he was like, yes, get off the bus. I get off the bus. I bolt off. I get into the Uber and I'm like, thank you so much. Thank you so, so much. Like, I didn't know what I was going to do. And he's like, we got you. We're going to get home.
Victory.
Made it home before the sunrise. Had just the best day ever. New York provided with a car at the end of the night. You know, I really thought we were going to get stranded, but no, it worked out. And it was truly a great day the entire day. And yeah, that's my best night in New York story.
I love this story so much. And all I'm thinking about is all of these people I talk to, they're like, New York is over, which is why I'm doing this whole season. It's like, no, you aren't doing things. You can look at this. Look at this. You were out until 6 in the morning. You were eating Mexican food. You were in a park. You were dancing. You were like naked in a hot tub. You were doing every single opportunity is available to you. So stop saying New York isn't fun. Stop saying New York is dead or whatever the hell people are saying, because here it is. Here is the prime example of just going out there, saying yes to everything, putting together a great outfit because you have no idea what's going to happen and just waiting to see the way the night is going. to unfold. It is seriously so fucking fun. And I just, now I want to do this. Now I'm just thinking about those spring days in New York when it's starting and everyone's so optimistic. It is so, so, so fun. And I don't think there's many people who have got to experience that hot tub. So that's a real feather in your New Yorker cap. So get to carry that one with you, Miss Leila.
Yeah, first time of House of Yes, I went in the naked jacuzzi.
Why the hell not? Get in the naked jacuzzi. I don't know. I might be too old for that these days. But for everyone else, if you get offered a naked jacuzzi and they're soaping you up beforehand, you go and do it. I love that story so, so, so much. The young people are out here doing it, folks. Join in with them, please. All right. Let me ask you my last and final question of the show. And that is, what is your favorite thing about New York City?
Probably the culture and all of the cultures that are here. There's no place where you have everybody and every opinion and every cuisine and every walk of life all in one space and every language. Just there's everything here. That to me is the reason to be here. Because to me, the reason to be here is not, you know, the stunning nature, right, or the stars or the waterfront property. And like, that's the thing. It's like New York provides, like, you know, if you're not having fun in New York in this type of culture, you're not trying hard enough. And you can have an amazing day just by saying yes to leaving your house and saying yes to the opportunities that present themselves in front of you. And if you don't want to do that, that's fine. But that's not that New York isn't fun. Maybe that's just that you're not that fun.
You're basically saying our, you know, they had fun preamble or like mantra or whatever it would be, because these are all the things I'm always saying. And I agree with you. Every element of the culture, whatever it would be, just like you said, food, art, people, languages, whatever, it is unlike anywhere else in the world. And yeah, if you're not having fun, you're not fun. It's your fault. That is the most important part of the show. Leila, thank you so much for talking with me and for telling that awesome, awesome, super fun story. Loved hearing it.
Thank you for having me. It's been a blast.
Most of all, thanks, New York. They had fun. Leila, so good.